The National Theatre in Prague is known as the alma mater of Czech opera and is the national monument of Czech history and art. The National Theatre belongs to the most important Czech cultural institutions with a rich artistic tradition, which helps to preserve and develop the most important features of the nation, the Czech language, and a sense for a Czech musical and dramatic way of thinking. Today, the National Theatre consists of three artistic ensembles, opera, ballet and drama. They alternate in their performances in the historic building of the National Theatre. In the Theatre of the Estates and in the Colorat Theatre, all three artistic ensembles select their repertoire both from classical heritage and modern authors. The cornerstone of the National Theatre was laid on the 16th of May 1868, but the idea of building a theatre dates back to the autumn of 1844 at the gatherings of patriots in Prague. An application was submitted by František Palacký to the Provincial Committee of the Czech Assembly on the 29th of January 1845, requesting the privilege of constructing, furnishing, maintaining and managing of an independent Czech theatre. The National Theatre was opened for the first time on the 11th of June 1881 to honour the visit of Crown Prince Rudolf of Austria. Frederick Smetana's opera Libius was given its world premiere, conducted by Adolf Čech. Another 11 performances were presented after that. Then the theatre was closed down to enable the completion of the finishing touches. While this work was underway, a fire broke out on the 12th of August 1881, which destroyed the Copper Dome, the auditorium and the stage of the theatre. The fire was seen as a national catastrophe and was met with a mighty wave of determination to take up a new collection. Within 47 days, 1 million guldens were collected. This national enthusiasm, however, did not correspond to the behind-the-scenes battles that flared up following the catastrophe. Architect Josef Zetek was no longer in the running, and his pupil architect Joseph Schultz was summoned to work on the reconstruction. He was the one to assert the expansion of the edifice to include the block of flats belonging to Dr. Polak that was situated behind the building of the Provisional Theatre. He made this building a part of the National Theatre and simultaneously changed somewhat the area of the auditorium to improve visibility. He did, however, take into account with utmost sensitivity the style of Zetek's design, and so he managed to merge three buildings by various architects to form an absolute unity of style.